Greg Warmoth is back with us here on Sirius 209 and XM 146. Thank you for doing this. I know it's been a busy, crazy morning, Greg. Good morning.
Good morning. Yeah, it's always good to be with you guys and give you whatever information we can, because clearly this is not a golf story. This is an international news story. And, you know, and now I know you've watched all this unfold. Now there's all this speculation that maybe the Florida Highway Patrol, in responding to Tiger Woods' house on that Thanksgiving night or early Friday morning, was a little incomplete, because if there was, in fact, alcohol, which apparently Elon mentioned that there was in Tiger's system, and possibly Ambien and Vicodin, you know, was he driving under the influence? Should the citation have been worse? And maybe, I mean, as you look at this, nothing surprises me. Let me just say that. So whatever comes today and comes tomorrow and the next day won't surprise me, because every day it's like a bombshell is dropped on this, and you can only imagine that the walls have to be closing in on Tiger Woods and his family right now. I don't know, TJ. I don't know when we'll see Tiger again. And of course, I'm certain your listeners are aware that his best man is being married, the guy that allegedly bought the ticket to Australia where Tiger was playing golf for Rachel Yucatel. And now Tiger has said through, I guess, his people that he will not be attending that wedding, because I'm certain he wanted to get that word out there so it wouldn't be a circus, although it probably will be anyway, because people want the comments from his buddy and the guy that runs the, you know, Tiger Woods design company, one of his, I guess, longtime friends. So at every twist and turn, if you're within the Tiger camp, this is affecting you. And I can't. The one thing that I cannot believe in all this, TJ, they have the wealth to do it. I cannot believe that Elon Woods is not either out of that neighborhood or out of the country right now while all this is happening, because at least that would give her some solace, or, you know, some reprieve from being inside the gates of Isleworth, where it's, while it's a big community, it's a small community, if you know what I mean.